happy to be alive.
That's so scary. So you couldn't get anywhere in my neighborhood without walking by Granny Pfeiffer's house, a coral-peeling weathered flat that looked like dessert cake, and white frosting awnings, sugar and decay, and crab apple trees that spilled these fat bitter bulbs on the lawn that she religiously watered, I'm talking about once in the morning and again at dusk, so shuffling out the house on pink sponge rolls, a corduroy house she made for me, with the heat pressed down and flat. Still, she would sit up straight, white lace glove, yes ma'am, delicious.
You couldn't move anywhere around my house without greeting all the old Spanish ladies your mama had
come in the living room. Yes, that's Hacienda.
No one ever made appointments, no. These women were too close to those kinds of commitments dressed in their floral nightgowns. Sábado Gigante was an evening ritual, the background music to women whose business it was to be only cause in their eye, my lesson.
No me diga eso.
To sip their cafecitos in this house, women sat close enough to touch each other's knees. Yeah. Made some cultural arrogance, they knew how necessary it was to fill a space and how often they'd been drowned by their own silence.
Okay, if you wanted to get to the corner store in my neighborhood, you had to go by my homies, Binky and Bunky's house. A red brick ranch-style home that kept its secrets pushed behind painted and repainted white screen door with that inevitable beehive stuck just above it. Everything about that house had a stain. But all fried everything, all the time. Everything, oxtails and chicken and sausages, right? I said, you ain't never just walked by, no. You stopped in, you set your shoes by the door. You listened for the rumble, said yes please to sweet potato pie, and maybe messed around and got your hair pressed out if Miss Susie felt like climbing in to tackle the bramble and quiet your brush fire mountain.
This house, I learned how wide a family can be, how to wrap its arms around your waist in a tin foil of hot and empanadas firma dropped down from the 18th floor. How all these women were my abuelas and tías. How they gave me bendición. These were the I wish you would women, the I'm gonna be as loud as I wanna be women, the you look bien gorda women, the you look bien flaquita women. There ain't nothing good enough for these women, women whose hearts were big and tans were rough, whose kitchen counters clean, and now it's dirty when they need to be.
Come on, come on.
Here, you learn about the community, that women can hold for one another, and how a living can be calm and
Okay, if you wanted to get to the playground in my neighborhood,